Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. I know I taught all of you that song in church years and years ago. We're here today to celebrate Charlie James' homegoing. I give honor to God, who's the head of my life, who takes care of me each and every day. And we thank God for this opportunity of being here today under the circumstances, but we have not given and the Lord gives it for us. And we're going to follow this. And so first of all, I'm going to have a scripture. My sister, Mary Mann.
Praise the Lord.
I'll be coming from Isaiah 57, 1 and 2. The righteous perish, and no one ponders in his heart. Devout men are taken away, and no one understands the righteousness are taken away to be spared from evil. Those who walk uprightly enter into peace. They find rest as they lie in death. I read Isaiah 57, 1 and 2. May it be a blessing to the hearers and doers of his holy word. Amen.
Amen.
As we continue on with this service, I want to say that we're here for homegoing, and the homegoing in service is for the people because the deceased is gone. So what I'd like for you to do right now, clap your hand and give God some praise.
Known as Charlie James Hall. Charlie was the second of six children born to Eddie May Pompey. His father was Flynn Hall. Charlie was the apple of his maternal grandmother Mary's eye. He was very close to his Aunt Millie, who became his surrogate mother after the death of his mom. Charlie spent the early years of his life in Mobile, Alabama. He later moved with his family to Los Angeles, California. He was blessed to be born into a God-fearing, love-centered family and accepted Christ as his Lord and Savior at a young age. He spent many years working as a plastics fabricator for North American Rockwell, building aerospace ships. He subsequently became a custodian at El Camino Community College in Torrance, California. Charlie's mother, father, and stepfather, Cornelius Williams, preceded him in death. He also had one sister, Brenda Williams, one brother, Lewis Williams, and a stepbrother, Cornelius Williams, to transition before him. He leaves to mourn brothers Palmer Richardson, Wally Kalia, and Theodore Ted Williams, stepbrother Ivan Williams, his Aunt Gloria, Reverend Gloria Arrington, nieces, nephews, and cousins.
Anyone that would like to make remarks, don't be bashful. I'd like for you to come forward if you have a reflection regarding the Charlie James.
Good morning.
scripture that comes to mind. It says to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And I really believe that in the soul, there is a better place. I want to tell you that Uncle Charlie, that I called him, was not only a great dresser, but also a great fried cook. He would burn some bacon every now and then. I remember as a kid, we lived right down the street on 105th and Doty. And him and my mom, Sheila Williams, were very close. They were running buddies once upon a time. And Charlie would come by and watch my little brother, Sean, and me and make sure that we were okay. He always was protective of his brother Lewis Williams' children. I loved Uncle Charlie. He brought a lot of joy and taught me a lot of things. And one of the things I'll never forget is Uncle Charlie had these red candy apple shoes that he used to sport, and this long trench leather jacket. He had style. And he always told us, live your best life. So family, we're going to miss him. But I know that he's with the Lord. And that's what we all have to strive for, is to get to the place in God and to fulfill our purpose here on earth. I thank God for Uncle Charlie. He also reminded me of Shaft. You know how Shaft had those long trench jackets and would walk in, and Charlie had the swag with him. You know, I think once upon a time he even had his hair straight. I can't remember, but I think he had his hair straight once upon a time. Oh, man. I'm going to miss Uncle Charlie, but God blessed him. He lived to be in his 80s. Wow. You know, people are not living past 18 nowadays, man. It's crazy out here. But I loved Uncle Charlie. I was blessed to see him before he passed. And thank you, family, for wrapping your arms around Uncle Charlie. We're all going to miss him. He touched all of our lives. Thank you.
The gang on the east side of South Los Angeles. I met him, I guess, when I was in high school. It was Charles. I remember the days. Charles had a fantastic 57 Chevy. And also, he was a good dresser. We had a lot of fun. And we stayed friends over the years. I guess it's been about 50 or 60 years. But I always remember to call and stay in touch with Charles. And I don't believe I've talked to him in over a year, but that conversation was like old times. And we have a lot of good memories. And I'm going to miss him, of course. house, myself. Neighborhood ladies. He liked the ladies quite a bit. And I was fortunate enough to keep that conversation going over the years, ups and downs. And I remember so many of the times that we had conversation. I just had to come and be here for him. I'm sorry that I didn't get to see him in the last year because of the pandemic, but Charles was a precious friend of ours and of mine, and condolences to the family, and may God bless him and keep him in perfect peace. It's wonderful to be here. Thank you.
I could talk about Charlie all day. I have so many memories of Charlie. And like Sandra said, he had the car that he loved. And that's one of the first memories I had of Charlie, was him and his car. And we would be outside playing, and we knew not to touch it. But sometimes he would come out, and we would be looking at it and get in trouble. And as a kid, I was afraid because I grew to love Charlie, and I can say that over the past few years, Charlie called me every day. Jeanette, did you call me? And I'm like, no, Charlie, I didn't call you. I got up because I was moved by something that I said, that the funeral is not for the deceased, it's for the ones of us living. And I was moved because I have to take my hat off to our aunt. You know, she's buried a mother and father, 15 siblings, two husbands, three kids, and now she's going through nieces and nephews, and she's still doing the job that she took that she accepted from Christ as a woman of God, as a minister, and she's not letting it get her down. And I say, let's give Auntie a hand. An example of what a God-fearing person should be. And I'd like to personally say thank you.
I'd like to thank each and every one of you, and it's because of God's love and because of him keeping me. I tell everybody every day, God has not let my, he hasn't let my head go underwater yet. So he has me here to continue to take care of you guys. And I know that each and every one of you have been through some trials and tribulations, some ups and some downs, and so on. I want to tell you a story before I go into my service sermon. I hope you can listen attentively and understand it. As Jeanette has said, I'm from a family of 16 siblings. And listen to this story. I had a sister named Eddie Mae that was Charlie Jane's mother. I had a brother named Julius. And as you listen to the story attentively, Eddie Mae had a set of twins. And so when she had them, the hospital told Eddie Mae, you have to name these children right away. They have to be named because we have to put them on a birth certificate. So she said, oh my goodness, what am I gonna do? So she was heavily sedated, and they made a suggestion that somebody would name the twins. And so guess what? My brother Julius. And those, most of you know Julius. And he was the one that was designated to name the twins. And when Eddie Mae woke up, she said, who named my twins? Julius named the twin. So, oh my God. Y'all know Julius don't know anything about naming no twins. So she asked, what did he name the girl? He named the girl Denise. What did he name the boy? I have so many, the good, the bad, and the ugly. One bomb memories of Charlie James. He was one character after the other, as Stevie and Jeanette and everybody was saying. Charlie James was something else. My mother had him spoiled because he lived with her. After Eddie Mae went to college and came, and his daddy, Glenn Hall, was in New York. And after my mother passed, Charlie James had to come to California to his mother, and which he was absolutely spoiled. And after my mother got through spoiling him, his mother got through spoiling him, then my sister, Eddie Mae, spoiled him. So it was spoiling. As you can see, he was like 80 some odd years old, and I'm 88. And he always said I was jealous of him. Gloria Dean is jealous of me, and I have a son that's going to be with the Lord named Eric. And Eric said, Mama, don't mock Charlie James how you talk, because you make me laugh so hard. I don't know what to do. Just stop and cut it out. And I want to share, as I say, I always tell people when I go to a funeral, you see the beginning of the life, the ending of the life, and there's a little dash in between birth and death. And I want to know, how is your dash? Let your dash be right with the Lord. Because once you leave this place, your life is in that dash. I was sitting there thinking about all the times that all of us as a family have had. Things that we have gone through, hard times, up, down, down. But make sure that your dash is right, because that's your life while you're living it. Are you keeping in tune with God and with your life and doing the things that God would want you to do? So I'm asking you to do that, not only as Reverend Arrington, but as your auntie, friend, and relative. Make sure, and if people make this statement, he's in a better place. They said the same thing about my daughter, Wateria, and Aunt Eric, and Anthony, and my daughter-in-law, and everybody in a better place this year. But my desire is that they would be in this place. But we know that they've gone to be with a better place. So we're going to have a few scriptures from the Word of God because of the limited amount of time. And then we're going to let you continue with the service. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come at this time to thank you for the many blessings that thou hast bestowed upon us. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your things that you have taken us through. Lord, we thank you that you woke us up this morning, clothed us in our right mind, gave us a portion of our health and strength, and started us out on our way. We thank you for the safe trip here, dear Heavenly Father, and keeping us from hurt, harm, and danger, and asking you to bless each and every one of us with the memories of Charlie James. We thank you, Lord. Amen and amen.
Amen.
I wanted to speak to you today just a few words from the scripture, and it's taken from 1 Thessalonians. And it says in 1 Thessalonians, believers who die, brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be uninformed about those who sleep in death, so that you do not grieve like the rest of mankind who have no hope. You may not have any hope, but if they die in the Lord, they will grieve that Jesus died. If Jesus is going to come back, and those that have already fallen asleep, Jesus is going to come back, and he's going to bring those that are asleep with him. And it says, according to the Lord's word, we tell you that we who are still alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will certainly not receive those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will come. That's a blessing within itself. He's not going to send James, John, Paul, or nobody else. He's going to come. And one day you get ready. A preacher said a funeral a while back that a young lady passed away, and everybody was just, she was young, and her death was just like a surprise. It's a surprise going to be again. And that surprise is when the heavens open up and Jesus is going to appear.
Yes.
And I know that you have heard from birth, as long as you can remember, your mother, myself, others, telling you that we're living in the last days. And we are living in the last days. And Jesus is going to come back and get those of us that are left. And those that have gone on, he's going to bring them with him. And it's something that the clouds is going to open up. They're calling somebody, something's wrong with the weather, and this and that and the other. And well, nothing's wrong with the weather. God's just getting ready to come back, and we're living in the last days, and we have to be prepared for it, that we won't be surprised when the clouds open up.
Yes.
Look at the weather condition now. Sometimes it's cold, sometimes it's hot. We don't know what to put on. And these young people are about to die because of the heat. And I have a daughter that lives with, oh, it's so hot, it's so hot. I said, my salute, my thing to you is this. Don't go to hell, because it's hotter than that in hell. If you think it's hot here, and she's saved, but I'd be teasing about the heat. And so what they're saying is that the weather condition, and then people talk about it, and that's not talk about the weather, that's God's weather. God is doing some things. And when he opened up in heaven, then those of us that know him, including Charlie Tank, we're going to be with him. For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, and with the voice of the archangels, and with the trumpet of all God, and the death of Christ will rise again first. Those that are dead will rise again. We'll see all of them again. And we who are still alive and left will be caught up together. Isn't that a blessing?
Yes.
We're going to be caught up again. A lot of people are talking about the undertaker. I'm looking for the uppertaker.
Yes.
And that's the way we're going to be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we'll be with him forever. Isn't it a blessing to think about the coming? And we're going to be with him. We're not going to have to worry about the high prices of gas. We're not going to have to worry about the high prices of rent, whether it's a mortgage or whether it's rent. We're not going to have to worry about the high prices of food. And I was sharing with my niece in the car, I'm not worried about any of it. Because you know what? I know I taught you this and you've heard this before, that God said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. And if you know that, and people be panicking, oh, I'm going to get a whole bunch of this. No. I said, God is not going to leave me. He's not going to forbid those of us that he loved, those of us that he cared about. And I can say years ago, some of it before, a lot of you were even born, God took care of us. Everybody's talking about the virus. The virus is one thing. But before they had the virus, they had the polio shot, I think they called it. Then they had the vaccine. Now they have one for shingles. There's always something on this earth, because this earth's not a perfect place. Something is all threatened out thyself because of evildoers.
That's right.
The word of God said they're going to soon be cut off.
Yes.
Like green grass. Don't worry. And my pastor always tells us, if you pray, don't worry.
Mm-hmm.
And if you worry, don't pray.
Amen.
Don't worry. Look up, because Jesus is soon to come back to get those of us that he loves so much. And he's going to take us away in the clouds with him. God bless you.
Amen.
Come on, let's appreciate her. To those of you who came out to show your love and support to this family on today, we express our gratitude to you as well. This is going to conclude our portion of our chapel service. I'm going to ask those of you who do choose to view, I'm going to ask you to form a line to my left, your right. And once you've had your final viewing, if you do choose to join us for the interment portion of our services, I'm going to ask you to go to your vehicles. Everyone will follow right behind the back of the hearse to the interment site. Again, may God continue to bless and keep all of you, is our prayer. Again, if you would like to view, please form a line to my left, your right.
Thank you.
gave me a song.
You gave me a song that you love.
Now I know I can go on.
Now I can go on, cause you love me.
Thank you, Jesus.
State your name, my social security number. I'm just kidding. The descendants of the Pompeys, right? All right. Well, let's take that shot, though.
But I'm grateful, Jesus.
It's a mystery to me now. I'm glad to see Jesus.
Hallelujah.
When all hope was gone, you loved me.
Lord, you gave me a song.
You gave me a song that you loved me.
I'll never forget you, Jesus.
Now I can go on, cause you loved me.
It's a mystery.
It's a mystery to me now. I'm glad to see Jesus.
I'll love you, Jesus. And now I know.
What it really means.
Your love is everlasting.
What it really means.
Thank you, Jesus.
What it really means to love.
Your love endureth forever. Thank you, Jesus.